Hello everyone, thank you for joining us today for our Softengine webinar. This webinar will be featuring bank statement processing with our top Softengine consultants, Cam Luong and Brian Butland. Some of the things we're going to go over here today are going to include importing your bank statements as well as automate your reconciliation process, saving you a ton of time and hopefully some money. And we look forward to providing that information for you here today. Thank you guys so much for joining, and I will let the experts take it from here. Take it away, guys.
Thank you for attending today's webinar on bank statement processing. My name is Brian Butland. We also have Cam Luong with us. I'll be going over the features of the product and why it's used. Cam will be walking through a demonstration of bank statement processing. And without further ado, we can get started. So why would you use this product? In many situations when our customers are performing bank reconciliations, they are working with an online bank statement or a printed bank statement. What the bank statement processing feature allows our customers to do is to import that bank statement into SAP and automatically have it utilize transactions or perform transactions. There is a simple setting under the company details basic initialization tab that can be enabled. It's important to understand that once it's enabled, it does build tables and modifies forms. So we need to be really sure we want to do it. And once that setting is enabled and you've logged out and logged back in, you need to understand that there'll be an add-on that needs to start as well. And that add-on is called the Electronic File Manager. So with the Electronic File Manager, it can perform the bank statement imports, but it also will replace the functionality to create ACH payment files or EFT payment files. Please understand that while the payment engine and the Electronic File Manager can coexist, because the Electronic File Manager has the same features, it's redundant to have both add-ons running at the same time. And once the Electronic File Manager has been fully installed and initialized, the features of the Payment Engine add-on will not work for creating those payment files. Now, the bank statement file formats come in varying types and sizes and different definitions. In the sample that we're going to walk through, that Cam is going to demonstrate, we're using Bank of America's Bank Administration Institute codes. And the format they've named it is BAI2. So I believe the configuration is relatively straightforward, and Softengine is always willing to perform these steps for you and to help make your bank reconciliation procedures more efficient. Okay, so what you're going to see in the demonstration, you're going to see the configuration of bank statement processing. You're also going to see the actual importing of a bank statement, a sample bank statement, and then how the bank reconciliation is performed with the coded transactions that we've built for you. So at this point, I'll turn it over to Cam. Cam, feel free, take it away.
All right, thank you, Brian. I'm gonna switch over to my screen now. Okay, so as Brian said, to turn on that feature, we would have to go into the administration system, and then company detail. Then we'll be going into the basic tab, and there will be a checkbox under the house bank information, where it's install bank statement processing. Once, like he said, once this is installed and running, it's not reversible. So there will be a warning once you do a checkbox that you had to click OK to actually start the install. And once it's installed, you will not be able to uncheck this box. What it does is it will create pretty much new tables throughout the SAP system and also new fields throughout the SAP system. Another thing that it will install will be the add-on, the EFM format definition add-ons. As you can see here, we have already installed it and already connected. This will help us to create the electronic file format for the importing. And I will show that in a little bit in the demonstration. So once that is installed, we can go into setup, banking, bank statement processing, and we would have to set up the internal bank operation code. What this do is you will point out the code that you use inside SAP Business One and what kind of a document that it will create or post when it processes that bank statement. So as an example that we have in here, it will be pretty much for a business partner from and to bank. But you can also, of course, assign to GL account or even just ignore the whole rule itself on the bank statement. So once you create your internal code, then you will have to create the external code. And I have already created some. The external code are pretty much what you see on the bank statement. And this will pinpoint each row in the bank statement to be what it is, so then SAP would understand. So all these external code are actually pulled from that BAI2 file. And as you can see here, this is the Bank America table that they have. They will actually show you the code number that they have and then the name or what it is for that code. And to add it, all you have to do is pretty much put in the code that you use, or you could we could help you enter all these too. So I could do, let's just say the credit here, 169. Just have to type in 169 there. We could pay description there and then assign it to the internal code. So I could just say credit. And that's pretty much it. And then you could save, go OK. So once you got the external code set up, you would actually need to know the name that you assign to. Then you go into the bank setup. And in the bank setup now, since we use a Bank America, we could go across the Bank America and actually set that external code to be used for that Bank America. And you would just pretty much just select that name that you want to use. And then I could probably just do this. Then you could see update. Then okay. Then now it will use that external code for that bank. After you set up for the bank, then now you have to set up the house bank account, which you will have to choose which account that you are doing the import of the file for. Example, the sample that we're doing for is this bank account. And now on the right side of that, since we turn it on, they added few more columns. And to make sure that you want to import those files, you got to make sure you checkbox that you want to import to bank statement. And then you have to select the electronic file that you want to use by just click on the arrows and then select the one you want to use and go OK. And this will be created by the electronic file format add-on that we turned on earlier, which can be found on under tools and then the electronic file manager. I have already opened that under here. And this is where we create the electronic files and to help mapping the bank statement that you are getting from your bank to which data it is inside SAP Business One. It's pretty much it's telling the bank statement details like their bank name, the statement date, statement ID, the account number that's going to be importing, and then the starting balance, ending balance of that statement. And then on each row, then it will say what type of transaction it is. If there's a customer name, customer code, they will bring in. And then is it a credit or a debit, it will bring in, and any reference number along with that. So this once we set all this up on an electronic file, we can save that file. So I could save that file into our folder first. And then you could go back over here and you could actually right click, assign that format project. And pick that file that we have just saved. Then it will use that format. And go ahead and click update. Okay. And make sure that it's the same name that you have there. Then you click update. And okay. So once all that is set up, now you could set up the criteria for the automation of the bank processing. So you could go back to setup, banking, bank statement processing, and then the matching criteria. For this example, we are just doing the document. So there will be rules that they will check with. So we will check each row to see if the customer name matching inside SAP Business One, and then it will check if the balance of that document matching any document balance inside Business One, and it also would check the code. And there's many different options that you could choose from. These are just example that we use. So there will be three rounds which they will make. So then if any of these rules does not match, it will actually go to the second round. And then the second round will check if rule number one will pass or not, and then rule number two, all the rule had to pass for it to match the documents. So if one of this does not match, then we'll go round three, and then if even this doesn't match, then it will just keep it blank for you to actually edit it yourself, which we will show that in the demonstration also later on. So once you set up all the criteria here, you can save it. Then now we are ready to import the file. To import the file, you would go into banking, bank statement processing. Make sure you select the bank that you are going to import, and then the account that you are going to import. We will import a sample file that we created, which you can see here. It's pretty much this are the header detail that is provided to us, and then each row's detail here. So right now we'll have three rows in this bank statement. And so I will import that right now. So to import, you just have to click on import from file, choose that file that you want to import, and it will process that file. As you can see here, it will tell us that there's a warning where there's some customer name and code that did not match, which is okay. But so it will still import those three statement row. And this is my number six, bank statement number six. Then once you see that is successful, you go ahead and just close that window, and they will add that draft in there for you. It added a draft because we will still have to finalize it to reconcile. So all you have to do is just go ahead and double click that row. It will open up the detail. And as you can see, they bring in the bank account, the bank that is imported, the statement ID or statement number, the balances that's inside that file, and then the three rows that was inside the file. And As you can see, the operation code is the external code that they have that point to the internal code that was set, that we set up earlier. So once we have this, now we could do a posting proposal, and that will activate that criteria that we set up earlier. So if I click on this, as you can see, they automatically match the document that inside SAP with that transaction inside a bank statement. And so far, this is only two that it matched, because the last one, that warning that we had earlier, say that it did not match any business partner. So now we manually, we could actually select that business partner as we know it. So I know that is this business partner right here. So once you selected that, you could go ahead and click on the posting proposal again, and it will automatically match that document with the SAP Business One documents. So once all the roles are actually cleared, as you can see, is all checkbox cleared, you could actually finalize this bank statement now. And when you finalize the bank statement, what it does is it automatically creates all the incoming payment and outgoing payment, depend on the business partner and depend on what document that it was matching with. So as you can see, the first one is the invoice for one of the customer. And if we go to the relationship map for that invoice, you could see that the incoming payment that was generated from the bank processing. So the same goes with the vendors. So if I click on one of the vendors here, let me go back. I have to open this up, see. And then you could see that is from the AP invoice. You could open up that AP invoice, go to relationship map, and you could see that they create the outgoing payment for that vendor. And that is it for this point. Any questions?
Softengine, solutions that impact the bottom line.